Welcome back to Numbers on the Board.
Numbers on the Board, yes!
We're here today before the NBA draft, man. Everybody is going to see some new people into the NBA. It's a cool 2 days now. It's a cool 2 days. We get to see a bunch of players into the league. Before we get into our mock draft, yes, we will be drafted today. As some people that don't really hop into college basketball too much, we're going to do our best. Before we do that, I want to remind you that we have a live show coming to Vegas for Summer League, NOTBLive.com if you want to get tickets. Or we got meet and greet tickets. We got general admission tickets, special guests, free food, swag, good times, good vibes in Vegas. So if you're going to be there, be sure to tune in. And then also tomorrow, for the NBA draft, we will be going live on ESPN's YouTube channel at 8 o'clock Eastern to do some draft coverage as well. So go on ahead and tune in for that too. All right. All the housekeeping is done. How y'all feeling?
Feeling good. And you know, it's a little rainy morning.
Yes.
Like, that sleep was hitting so good this morning.
Yeah, it really was. I didn't want to get up. That's why I was a little late.
Yeah, I turned my alarm off. I was like, I'm going to just get up in a few minutes. I woke up. It was like 8:50. I was like, damn.
What time do you normally get up?
8:15.
Okay. Early riser.
I have to get up and like wake up. If I don't do that, I'm gonna feel all groggy and like not alert.
Okay.
Y'all need the same thing, or you just get up?
I just get up. Yeah.
No, I can't.
I need to kind of go through like my morning routine to wake up.
What's your morning routine besides?
Well, usually I don't know. I feel like it's going to the bathroom. Like I'll be on the toilet on my phone for like 15, 20 minutes, and then I'll hop in the shower. Nah, I'll be in the bathroom a long time when in the morning. I'm not gonna lie.
15, 20 minutes is a long time to be sitting on the can.
I think that's part of me like waking up.
Sometimes time fly past when you're sitting on your phone. You don't even realize it's 20
minutes. I do it all the time. Maybe not first thing in the morning, but I do it all the time. Danny be like, why do dudes take all day in the bathroom?
When that's because we just gonna have two bathrooms, so that's gonna be like, it's gonna be next level because I can be there as long as I want.
Are you gonna put carpet in there?
Put bath like mats in there.
Okay,
that's what he meant.
No, I meant carpet.
I thought that's what he meant too. Like you was gonna actually have carpet.
That's insane. I don't even think I've ever seen that in my life.
I don't want a bathroom with carpet.
No, that's why I don't think I've ever seen that in my life.
It's like mildew and
you know what I got
start to grow.
I got a golf thing. You know how like you have mats in your bathroom?
Yeah.
The mat I got, you can put, it's called like a pooper putter. So while you're in the toilet, you can just put. I haven't set it up because I'm like, this is crazy. But I did bags. I'm like, this is interesting.
But You're just having fun. You just bought something that you can have fun with. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
I try to use my morning, like when I first wake up and do my bathroom to like decompress. So I don't even bring my phone to the bathroom for my routine. Where I'm like going to the bathroom, shower, wash face, brush teeth, all that stuff. I don't have my phone with me. It just stays in the
bedroom. Whose brother is that does the TikToks? Somebody has a younger brother who does the TikToks.
Cam? You talking about Cam? I forget who. He has an NBA brother, but yes. I forget who his brother is.
I forgot who his brother is. And he have clips of people saying stuff like this. They be like, oh, no way.
Yeah.
You decompressing.
But it's like that's the way I wake up my morning. Because I feel like when I roll over and look at Twitter, it's just not going. You know
I decompress at night before I get in the shower. That's usually my decompress.
Oh, he did.
Who is this? Oh, Edwards.
Oh, yes.
What is his name, though? What's his first
Kessler
name?
Edwards.
Is it Kessler? Yeah. No, it's not Kessler Edwards. It is Kessler Edwards. Yes, it is.
From
Kessler
Pepperdine.
Cam Edwards, yep. Mm-hmm.
So, y'all know something that helps you like relax and eucalyptus in your shower? Hanging one of those plants up in your shower?
You do. I got the drops.
Oh, no. I go by the plants and like I hang them up. And like it helps the steam. It's supposed to help.
Where do you get the plants from?
Trader Joe's. They have them just sitting out.
Trader Joe's?
You just got money, boy.
Well, they're like $3 at Trader Joe's.
I just know Trader Joe's is typically pretty
expensive. Two bathrooms, though.
I do have two bathrooms.
Catch up, man.
I think that's like a mandatory thing.
All right.
One bathroom.
Do you have shower curtains?
Well, yes. I was saying
yeah,
when
well,
I
who
first
doesn't have shower there? Curtains?
Me.
Oh, you have the glass?
I have a glass door.
In my last house, I did have one that had a glass door. Now, and the other one, I needed a shower curtain. But yeah.
Who shops
Welcome
for shower?
Welcome to the off season.
Who shops for shower curtains in 2024? Get a squeegee. No, I'll just mess with you. Yeah, welcome to the off season, man. We can start with this draft stuff, but it's so many rumors.
Yeah.
Are y'all keeping y'all ear to the streets?
Of course.
Yeah.
What's been the main one that's caught y'all attention? Well, first and foremost, Scottie Barnes got extended.
Shout out to Scottie Barnes.
Kenny Atkinson is the Cavs coach. JJ Redick had his press conference. You tried to take a sound bite and come at me.
Oh, I was joking.
I know.
But it's a good tweet, though.
It backfired a little bit.
It did.
Because you have so many moments that I be forgetting. So I put the two that I remember, which was Reagan and Rocky.
Yeah.
Then other people was like, no, what about
Aretha Franklin?
Aretha Franklin, Gun in My Blue Purse.
Oh.
There was the Charlie Wilson. I'm like, how did I forget the Charlie Wilson? That's the classic.
That's probably my favorite one.
The Charlie Wilson one. And then I always remember Ronald Reagan, but I forget that you was like, my quarterback? And all the comments was like, his quarterback? I'm like, oh,
that is his name.
No, it's not. That's not even his name.
His real name is Ronald.
So he goes from Ronald to Robbie?
Yeah.
Or is his name Robert?
I'm pretty sure it's Robert.
No, we're not taking it. Yeah, you're right. Check fact this. Because this is
maybe I'm wrong.
Not knowing Dominique Wilkins, not knowing Dave being Ronald Reagan is one thing. But you do this so much where somebody be like, I don't know about that D-mail. It was Ronald to Robbie. And you'd be like, no, I'm sure. Just like yesterday, we was off camera talking about somebody having kids with somebody. You're like, no, this is the one right here, KB.
Yeah.
KB pulled her up. Oh, no, yeah, that's the one. You're right.
Like, I can't find it. I would need to go dig in the basement for a yearbook because it's probably habits of government.
But Ronald to Robbie is crazy.
Yeah, that doesn't even. But we've seen crazier things.
We have.
Yeah. So
we have.
I'm probably wrong. I'll take the L.
It's not an L to take. It's not an L to take. It's just like maybe you're right. Maybe you're right.
I thought the JJ Redick presser was pretty dope. I thought he answered all the questions in a way that I would want my future head coach to be answering. Bad news. No more podcasting, man. You know what I'm saying? Old man in the three is done. Mind the game is done. All of that stuff.
As expected.
But I thought
if a coach tried a podcast and coach.
I want to see it, bro.
Coaching takes too much time.
That would
the scenes just gonna be reviewing like the last game, especially if it was a loss, a bad one.
Would you know? This is a little bit different. In college basketball, a lot of coaches have their own radio show where they talk about the stuff that's been happening within the organization. So it doesn't happen in the NBA, but in college, like Coach K used to have a damn radio show and so on and so forth.
Coach K played less than half an NBA season.
No, I'm just saying it's not that out of the realm of possibility for a coach to do media as well. It's definitely better for him not to do it because the eyes are on you as the Lakers.
I just feel like if he were to do that and the team isn't performing at a high level, they're going to use the podcast as an scapegoat and say he shouldn't be doing that.
As they should, because, I mean, if you think about how much time goes into coaching.
Yeah.
Where do you have the time to do podcasts?
On a counterpoint, how little time goes into podcasting? You could do a podcast episode in 30 minutes. Send it off to an editor.
He does not do that.
But he could, is what I'm saying.
It wouldn't be the same podcast. His should be hours. For him to go from hours to 30 minutes all of a sudden?
He definitely has 30-minute, 40-minute episodes where he has like legs on. Legs comes in to do like their three best things, stuff like that.
His best ones to me is when they get into that detail.
Either way, he won't be doing it anymore. And that makes sense.
Good job, JJ. Be smart. Take your job serious.
That's crazy. We got what? How many episodes of him and Bron?
Who was that?
Seven, eight?
Yeah, not too many for sure.
We got such a small sample size of what could have been such a great podcast. Mm-hmm.
How many of those episodes did you watch?
Maybe like two.
It's not bad. I don't think it's
I think I more so saw clip outs on reels and shorts versus actually watching the whole podcast.
Mm-hmm. It was a good show.
It was.
But guess what? That means one less show we got to compete with for that number one spot. Give us five stars,
baby. It was. I laughed because you said we got robbed of a great podcast, but you basically didn't watch it.
I watched some of it.
No, for sure. I don't know. I can't remember how many episodes, but if you say it's around eight and you watch two. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But no, I'm not. Shit, I'll probably watch three.
I'm going to go back and answer your question about the rumors. Probably the Jimmy Butler one. About him getting traded, because I really still just don't know where. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I guess maybe the Heat or not the Heat, Houston could be a destination or something like that, but that's a big
Me contract. And KB would love that. We were trying to. Well, did you draw up a trade to Houston?
I did draw
I
up
could
a trade
draw one,
it
but.
It didn't make sense, really.
It was
but
for that
I
Jalen
tried
Green,
it.
Right?
Yeah. I like him going back to Philly.
But don't we got ties to Houston?
he's from Texas, so maybe it's Houston. But Philly wouldn't make sense on paper, but it doesn't make sense from the Heat perspective, because why would I want the 16th overall pick in the 2028 first rounder for Jimmy Butler? I want like actual something tangible right now. But I love the idea from going back to Philly. It just doesn't make a lot of sense.
I mean, they can get signed and trade Tobias Harris.
22 looks good. And right.
I was honestly about to say that, honestly.
Oh, prayers up to my girl, too, Cam Brent.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She had a tough injury. But, yeah, 22 does look good in purple and gold.
For me, it's the Paul George stuff, man. That's one of the biggest dominoes this offseason, if not the biggest domino of the offseason. Because it does make sense for him to opt into that contract and then force his way out. Again, we mentioned it before. Similarly to what Chris Paul ended up doing before he ended up in Houston. And there's going to be teams looking for a Paul George type of player. As a plug-and-play, defensive-minded, can get you 20-plus points a game, low-lift type of guy where you're not really expecting him to change the chemistry at all. He's kind of plug-and-play. And for a lot of these teams, you can add him without him being the number two guy and feel like you have a real legitimate chance. I've just seen so many mocks trades of Paul George. I'm like, this one makes sense. This one don't. There are some teams I would love to see Paul George on.
Name him.
I would love to see him with the Golden State Warriors.
Yeah. Beautiful fit.
Would love to see that. The way they get it done is a little weird because it's a second apron team. Technically, with Chris Paul's $30 million, it's not fully guaranteed. But there's a world where like they guarantee him that money. That's $30 million that goes to the Clippers. And the Clippers, for some reason, have James Harden and Chris Paul on the same team. I don't understand why they would do that.
Well,
anymore.
No, James Harden is not waiting. Apparently, until Paul George makes his decisions for him to make his.
But what's
decisions.
His market?
I don't
the
know.
The Clippers.
Yeah, that's how I feel as well. I just don't know if there's a secret team waiting for James Harden.
Is there a
world
where now Kawhi requests a trade? Like, is this the domino? Like, if Paul George wanted out, Kawhi wanted to play with Paul George. Mm-hmm. They agreed to go to L.A. If Paul George wants out, Kawhi Leonard may also be like, you know what? Maybe. I don't really want to be here.
But I also feel he's played and seen that Paul George couldn't do it, so maybe he's a little bit okay
question,
with
Paul, I would question Kawhi and his team. Because what was the rush to sign an extension?
Maybe they thought Paul George was going to sign one as well.
They also didn't sign for a full max either. So yeah, I feel like that would have just been there the whole time. The window on the Clippers is closed at the end of the day. Everybody just need to realize that. Everybody won't realize that. Like, Steve Ballmer wants to keep the team together because they got the new arena and it's good enough to be the four seed, but not good enough to stay healthy.
Maybe Kawhi see that too. Maybe he see the writing on the wall of this team. Ain't really good enough for me to compete at the high level for a championship. And he's like, hey.
I feel like he's been working. Before he got to the Clippers, he worked for like 2 years to get to L.A. again. So it would be weird
and
for him
part
to be
of
like,
that is on him not being able to be healthy, too.
Yeah, he holds some responsibility. After I asked that question, he probably took it because he probably thought they was going to have a different ending to the season after they got hard and they was clicking. I forget when he signed the extension, but it was definitely before he was hurt and things like that. So, yeah, I mean, it ain't out the realm of possibilities. I don't know if – I feel like that would have had some type of smoke or some legs by now because the Paul George stuff is kind of – blowing up to look like he is going to leave in some form or fashion. I feel like we would have heard some type of, you know, wrinklings coming from that direction.
But I feel like Kawhi is also, his team is so hush-hush. Like
they can be, but like KB said, it was no surprise. Like when he went to the Raptors, we knew that was the 1 year and he was going to find his way to LA. So it's like, they are hush-hush on certain things, but then some things are just kind of like they're not so hush-hush. We knew he was unhappy when he was with the Spurs. That was like no secret. The only thing that was hush-hush was like the exact details of his injuries. Those are the things that we don't really know. But when he want to go somewhere, when, you know, they said big market, it's going to be New York or back home. And sure enough, he went New York or back home. Winning the championship was not going to keep him there. Winning the championship did not keep him there. Man was at Home Depot with boxes.
Yeah. They called him.
With no care in the world. Like, hey, y'all taking pictures?
They just have no first-round picks until 2030. So it's like they're all in. They've always been all in on this team. And it's just unfortunate they were never able to get over that hump. Because as they continue to get older, it's no reason for me to believe that next year is the one they're going to be healthy.
Yeah, it's tough.
Like, there's no reason to believe that. So I feel like they should just try to bite the bullet and try to maximize the assets. So trade Paul George to this team, if that means we get the 16th overall pick out of it, or trade him to that team, we can get 23 and 24 and some other people.
Unfortunately, they're not going to do that.
Yeah, no.
Unfortunately, it's going to be we'll take Tobias Harris because he's a win now player. Unfortunately, it's going to be DeMar DeRozan. What you over there doing? Because we just, you know what I mean? We need something here. Unfortunately, that's just going to be the way that they pivot, I personally believe. It's just funny how the free agency class is working out. Because, like, I'm obviously a Paul George fan. But even with me being a Paul George fan, like I was saying in the video I did yesterday, I'm aware of the perception of Paul George, and he's extremely polarizing because on one hand, he's like the laughing stock of like NBA Twitter sometimes. And then on the other hand, he's like all of these up and coming players' GOAT. Mm-hmm. Like he's their GOAT. And as much as I love Paul George, I've never put him with no damn GOAT in the conversation for me. But to see him kind of have control of an offseason or the free agent, he's the domino, is kind of interesting. But I do like this for him, and I hope that he does use this power and leverage in the correct way, because he could transition into a nice spot as he gets to the latter parts of his career, because I think any team that has him as the third option is perfect for him at this point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's why I like the Sixers. I love the Sixers fit, because the tandem of JoJo and Tyrese Maxey, it automatically makes him a third option. All of the attention Joel commands is going to open up so much for him. Like you said, low lift. The Warriors is nice.
I got another team.
Just don't stay. So part of me feels like Paul George is also a guy that would just be like, Kawhi, you want me to stay? like not even saying it like that, but it's just like, man, I don't want to do my dog dirty. We came here together. And we all know that kind of is unfinished business. But like KB said, it's hard for me to believe. Yeah,
did he ever say about like when he had left OKC with Russ? Because Russ left a little bit after that too. But I felt like that was kind of like his bro. It wasn't Kawhi, but that was like some. I came here to play with you.
Paul George got traded, and then Russ got traded, 3 weeks later?
So there was somewhere where he did say something of like, he knew Russ was finna get up out of it. Something like that. Like,
he told Russell about him, or he told Russ about it. So something it was like that.
It was the same thing. I'm gonna get out, and I know Kawhi go get out too.
Yeah, so he ain't leave nobody in the dark. Right. But yeah.
What about Milwaukee? For Paul George on the
side. I've tried to get them.
Like a Chris Middleton.
I had the trade drawn up.
Yeah, I've
tried.
It's hard because the second apron stuff.
But oh, yeah, the money has to be almost exactly.
And the Clippers can't aggregate, so they can't add anybody. It had to be Paul George.
I'm going
to
be real.
Because they just keep talking about how they want to change their core. I mean, they be getting older, right? I think Paul George is like a year older than Chris Middleton at this point. I guess always has been that way, but. Just try to find ways for Milwaukee to do the stuff that they rumored to do. It's just hard.
And especially when you don't have no draft assets that's worth trading.
Like, but like if you're the Clippers, hard. You're like, okay, well, we saw what Chris Middleton can
that's
be.
That's what I was going to say. Mm.
Least we can convince our fans that he's like a borderline all-star we got back in return.
As long as you get a healthy Kawhi, which regardless if you have Paul George, Chris Middleton, whatever is the replacement for Paul George, Kawhi is going to have to be healthy and available. Mm-hmm. As long as you got him, Chris Middleton is not a bad quote unquote replacement.
Yeah. And on top of that,
especially if you keep Harden.
The buzz around it is that like obviously they're looking the Bucks are looking to move Lopez and most likely Giannis is gonna be.
I read Bobby Portis yesterday. Pat Connaughton, Bobby Portis, and that 23rd pick is like a little package they dangling out there.
They can get you nobody.
And I was surprised. I thought Bobby Portis is the one that they
I thought Bobby Portis
but
was
maybe
like,
he has value.
Yeah. Because seems like the heart and soul of that team.
I would say that's Giannis, personally.
Well, I mean, yeah, Giannis is like the best player, but like I think Bobby's energy and that grit, like he plays like that toughness type mentality. That's
for sure. I just think we failed for the heart and soul thing with Marcus Smart last year. None of that shit even mattered. Marcus Smart was gone, and it was like this team is better than what it was. If you just get better players.
That's because they got Drew Holiday.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But like, so if you're upgrading Bobby Portis, the heart and soul stuff kind of goes away if we're just getting better pieces.
Yeah, I can see that. But that arena loves Bobby, man.
Oh, for sure. When we went there, it was a dude in a whole Bobby Portis jumpsuit, just face plastered all over his clothes.
When they go to timeout, though, that arena be chin Bobby. Yeah, Bobby.
I think both of y'all could be right. I think Draymond Green is the heart and soul of the Warriors. But, yeah, if you get LeBron James and he's a part of the deal, then the Warriors probably still can win the championship. Mm-hmm. But he was the heart and soul. I think Marcus Smart was the heart and soul of the team, but you went out and got Porzingis and Jrue Holiday. Then, yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah. They still won, for sure. I would love the Bucks to go out and make some big splash. Jimmy Butler, Paul George, or something like that. But it just I can't really find a way to make it happen.
Yeah.
I just can't. Jimmy Butler makes a lot of money, man.
Yes, he does.
He makes a lot of money and he's trying to make more.
Yeah. And I just don't see how what team is going to give him more. And why would they give him more?
I got a question to y'all, to a proposition. So follow me. In the NBA, not us, but just like the NBA, it seems that like load management was a thing that people didn't like, right? Mm-hmm. And teams want you to be available. But there's also this other thing on the other hand where like the most important part of the season is the playoffs.
Yeah.
And if you perform there, then that's all that matters. We're now seeing a situation where Jimmy Butler has done that in his tenure for the Heat. He's performed crazy in the playoffs, postseason. Yeah. And it's gotten them to two finals runs. They made the Eastern Conference Finals how many years? Was it every year besides this one?
Yeah, I believe so. Something like that.
It's crazy.
They did go on a stretch of making it consecutively.
And we're now in a position where the Heat are like, we ain't paying you. You got to be available. But I'm kind of confused because it's like he did what he's doing or he's done what a lot of teams are saying they want you to do, which is like perform at the highest level in the playoffs, carry you, go that length. And so I'm just trying to figure out how to – because there's no player that's going to play 82 games.
Okay. What, unless, yeah, I was just about to say.
Part of me also feels like they're kind of just moving on from that chapter. He's just getting up there in age, and it's been like – as much as they had success, it's been a ceiling on this team. Mm-hmm. Like, they've always been the underdogs in these big game matchups, and they really haven't came close to it.
The great organizations know when to pull the trigger or pull the plug on something. Mm-hmm. Typically, if we're talking about a guy that goes well past his prime on one team, it's like that guy has done something to win a championship, right? Dirk won a championship in 2011. Shit, we in 2019, he's still hooping even though he's not that good. Same thing with Kobe, same thing with all these one-team guys. Jimmy Butler's been phenomenal for the Miami Heat, but this organization is ran differently than most other organizations. Mm-hmm. While other organizations might keep him around because he's still All-NBA when he's hooping, they're like, hell, he ain't really been hooping over the last couple years.
Yeah.
And these are all speculation. Like, nobody from the Heat side have said that we trade in Jimmy Butler, but it's other people across the association that believe it's going to be the case. And it feels on brand for them. That's why I kind of buy it a little bit, because they've always been a team that's about getting the most out of players and out of assets. And waiting until Jimmy Butler's 36 years old to potentially try to trade him on the last year of his deal doesn't really make sense if you're the Miami Heat. So it's like, if we don't believe that Jimmy's going to be healthy, or we don't believe we can really build a competent team around him, let's go ahead and trade him a couple years left on his deal. We just see too many organizations in basketball wait until the last year and they get pennies on the dollar for an asset. And sure. The Heat are one of those teams that want to maximize.
Yeah, and Pat Riley said like he wants the extension and the money he's asking for somebody who's going to play. You know what I mean? I think they said Jimmy Butler hasn't played more than 64 games or something like that over the last few seasons. I asked that because then my next question, the real question is there any hope and belief, or not even hope, but do y'all believe that there is another way and another route for this Miami Heat team to pivot from Jimmy Butler and get to where they usually go to? Because they went from the Heat, the Heat, they've always been the Heat, but they went from the Heatles to like a little, and then they got right back into it with like Jimmy Butler, and it's like, can this team do it again? And the Heatles stuff, it's far away, but it ain't that far away from like the Shaq and Dwayne Wade championship years. So they kind of always have found, pretty much most of our lives, ways to pivot into.
In the last 24 seasons, they've missed the playoffs 5 times.
Is there a world or a route that y'all could see them? Could y'all see them taking a Brandon Ingram and all of a sudden Brandon Ingram hits a new height? Or is that run too much to believe in that they can keep doing that?
I think the door is always open. It's just, what are the assets you're giving up to get the better player in
there? Well, it's probably going to be something with Jimmy Butler being moved.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I think the two options is Paul George or Jimmy Butler. I mean, not Paul George or Brandon Ingram. Those are the two like all-star caliber wings out there that you could probably bring in to where you probably won't really miss a step, but you could probably keep going a little bit.
I'm just trying
Brandon
to think
Ingram
about,
he misses a lot of games too, if they're talking about guys. It's
and
not
Lou Dort hit him in the torture chamber. I'm like, oh, Brandon, are we good? You know what I'm saying?
he also had Mikhail looking like a not so all defensive, you know.
I'm thinking about
his best player wasn't there, Zion.
Oh, Zion wasn't there yet. How did they transition from these eras, right? So after the Heatles era, they had a few years where it was like Bosch before he had his heart condition?
Blood clot.
Blood clots.
And they ended up drafting Bam. And Bam has turned into a guy that's all NBA caliber. I don't think he's actually made it.
Hassan Whiteside they found too.
Yeah, and then they traded.
He was out there getting triple doubles with blocks.
Shout out to Portland, because if it wasn't for Portland, Jimmy Butler's not in Miami. Because they just took that money. Like Hassan Whiteside's one of those dudes who's like, he's there to get his 2K rating up. Like how much does he actually impact with it?
They had
stuff.
A lot of players play real. Like Josh Richardson had a really good stint for them.
Tyler Johnson
was really. But good the way they transitioned was we drafted well, like a Bam Adebayo or a Tyler Hero, and Justice then we saw a guy that didn't want to hit free agency technically, and we traded for him, and that's Jimmy Butler. And then we did some other stuff. We got some undrafted dudes. We got some the Jaime Jaquez.
They got lucky to even get Jimmy.
Yes, they did.
Because in the right world, but I mean.
But is it luck if it's Pat Riley?
We go back, and you're probably seeing Jimmy Butler stay on the Sixers if we go back.
You needed some malpractice from the 76ers in order to get Jimmy Butler.
For sure.
They had to choose Tobias Harris over him. Mm-hmm.
And you needed the Blazers to take Hassan Whiteside, which they did, and you needed the 76 to think that Josh Richardson was going to keep up the play that he was having with the Miami Heat. That Jimmy's trade is like a masterclass in deception.
In real time, we was like, "Damn, that's a good picker for the Heat." But we was also like, "Man, Josh Richardson could go over there."
Yeah, I thought it was a good trade. I think I graded like a B+. And Josh Richardson went over there and stunk it up for.
He
a
did.
Year.
He did. Now he's back on the Heat.
Yeah,
now he's back on the Heat.
Not too bad, but yeah, this trade is huge.
Yo, Miami Josh Richardson was like a prototype comp for me. Like I would go into the draft and I would find myself classifying all of these different people as like Josh, and I'm like, bro, everybody can't be Josh Richardson, but he was like a guy that could defend, shoot, handle it a little bit, like
athletic a little bit.
Him, KCP, they have like they had these molds that's just like a lot of guys are going to be 6'5", 6'4", you know what I mean, and try to defend and play with the ball, play off the ball, shoot, be able to catch and shoot. It's just like a perfect prototypical type of person to come into the league and play 3-and-D guard type
of
thing.
He was actually talking about like his play style recently on, I think with UD, and he was talking about how with the Heat, he was more comfortable because he had the ball in his hands, and mm-hmm. He was able to rock a little bit with the ball. Well, when he went to Dallas and he was playing with Luka, he said he really struggled because he didn't have the ball in his hands, mm-hmm. and he really struggled on like finding out how to fit in without having the ball. And like that's kind of crazy to see like a guy who can shoot and stuff, but like he needs that rhythm. Like he really needs
that
rhythm.
That's interesting to hear because yeah, I think a lot of players would like to have the basketball. I think even somebody like KCP probably came into the league. You got to understand, these dudes been number one options their entire life before they got here. But at some point, you or your team, your trainer, whatever, somebody in that corner has to be able to realize that your maximum potential is probably being able to play next to a Luka. It's not many teams in the 30 NBA teams that we have that is constantly going to allow Josh Richardson to rock out. Yeah. Not no indictment against Josh Richardson, but I think the allure of his fullest potential that would bring you in is to be able to think that he can guard. Occasionally he can play with the basketball to break something down if we need be, but then he's also going to be able to play off of a Luka Doncic or, you know, a Jimmy Butler or Ben Simmons when he was in Philly. But yeah, I've never seen it. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it showed up on my reels recently. Yeah. He was talking about it with UD. Oh, that's very interesting.
Yeah, that's super interesting because Josh Richardson is definitely a guy who I would have thought just had some tough shooting years. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? The shot just wasn't falling. Sometimes it's like that for shooters versus him saying, I need the raw, I need the rock. Yeah. I would think that would come from Caris LeVert or Spencer Dinwiddie. Like, man, I need the ball. Like, if you got Spencer Dinwiddie spotting up, I ain't really mad at Spencer Dinwiddie if the shot ain't falling because he kind of need to rock out a little bit.
Yeah. Is every Jimmy Butler trade extremely one-sided to the team that got Jimmy Butler?
No, because the Chicago Bulls trade was not as bad in the time. We only go off that with hindsight because y'all didn't deal with Lauri Markkanen the right way. But if you gave that to another team who knew what to do with Lauri Markkanen, Zach LaVine, Lauri Markkanen, that's a good little return.
Yeah, we have what, one playoff win since then?
And he didn't even do shit with the Timberwolves. Ain't like he went over there and had the Miami Heat runs.
Well, they did make the playoffs now for the Timberwolves at that time. And what that they was got, like Super Bowl.
4-1, 4-0 to the Rockets?
I don't think they won a game.
Okay.
But this straight after that is him getting out of Minnesota, and it was Robert Covington, Dario Saric, and a second-round pick.
Yeah, that one's nasty. That's nasty right there.
That's a steal.
They didn't even get a first-rounder in this trade, bro.
I feel like sometimes you just don't have the leverage.
I don't even feel like I remember a lot of stuff.
You couldn't even get Tobias. You couldn't get Tobias Harris? Because that team ended up being Ben, Joel, Jimmy, Tobias, J.J. Redick. Yeah. You couldn't get J.J. You couldn't get the specialist.
Well, Philly was probably like, hey, he was just
he just did the Rachel Nichols.
He was in there fighting y'all co-stars. Y'all got to get him off anyway. Here, we got this, and that, and this is the only thing we giving you.
Yeah.
We not giving you
y'all was in that running. Do you remember?
Portland?
The Portland wanted him.
I feel like every team probably wanted him.
That for sure. But y'all needed him. Like, needed a Jimmy Butler in terms of like lockdown wing.
Dame, CJ.
That was the Amino and Mo Harkless.
Exactly. Yeah. The history of that duo is probably a lot different.
If they get Jimmy?
Yeah. Because listen to that pack. If we reverse and rewind it to real time, for the Timberwolves' sake, Robert Covington was really good defensively. They thought they were getting a supreme 3-and-D guy. And Dario Saric was second in Rookie of the Year.
That's more appealing than Mo Harkless than Amino.
Yeah. By and far. What else did they get?
A second round pick.
That turned into a guy that never came over.
Okay. And then what was the trade? It was Josh Richardson for Jimmy.
This trade is huge.
I know Jimmy had to sign.
Josh Richardson, Hassan Whiteside are in it. Miles Leonard is in it. It's a big four-teamer. Turned into Jaime Jaquez is in here.
Who did it come from? Philly?
Came from the Clippers, but then it went to OKC, and then they acquired it from OKC. So it ended up getting traded like four times before. It ended up being Jaime Jaquez. But can you imagine if it was straight?
So you got Jimmy Butler and Jaime Jaquez.
Yeah. But it's a huge trade. Too convoluted. And then the next trade might be a steal as well. Who knows? He's only 34 years old, y'all.
I'm a big Jimmy.
He's an old 34.
I'm a big Jimmy Butler fan.
Played
all those minutes.
Yeah.
I'm a big Jimmy Butler fan. If you are a team that's willing to allow him to rock, Jimmy Butler is who Jimmy Butler is, and that's why I'm a fan of him. You got it. He need to go somewhere where like the Knicks would be good. Not because it's my team. I also don't want to get him because I feel like the Miami Heat are too smart. They're gonna want Josh Hart, Dante. They're gonna want
Julius Randle and Bogey Bogdanovich and 3 first-round picks.
We're not doing 3. Not doing 3. We giving you 3 to give him an extension that's worth almost $200 million? No. You got 24 and 25. But
a Randall Bam front court sounds kind of nasty, though.
He need to go somewhere he can come in and talk shit with people who not going to be easily
offended.
So you can't.
Man, he back with his guy Tibbs. That's the dynamic duo right there.
And you know, Tibbs going to let him rock. Definitely. Tibbs going
to
let him talk.
Tibbs will let him rock.
Back to it, Jimmy.
Did y'all see the Taj Gibson interview with the Tom Thibodeau?
Yeah.
Was that the Jeff Teague?
I don't remember. I just saw him. I didn't even know who he's talking to. They say he just get a call from Tom Thibodeau 3 a.m. and say, you in shape?
Yep.
Yeah. Yeah, I think
you'll be ready for tomorrow.
I think that was Jeff Teague. Because Jeff Teague said that he wanted him to come play for the Knicks. And Jeff Teague was like, no, I'm going to go over here with the Celtics. And he was like, I knew Thibs love because he said, what are you doing? And he said, sure enough, I went over there and got literally a cup of coffee with the Celtics and was gone.
I don't even remember him on the Celtics.
So I got a cup of coffee and was gone. Yeah, he needs to go somewhere where he can really. That's just Jimmy, bro. That's just Jimmy. Jimmy is going Jimmy, man. He going Jimmy. Send him back to a lot of teams he's played before. They could use him.
He would be interesting in L.A. too with the Lakers.
Mm-hmm.
That would be very good. Maybe he can really put that battery over there.
The only thing I don't like about them is their shooting, man.
Yeah, that's the first thing.
Bron, AD.
Hey, don't forget Bron shot 41% from 3 last year.
For sure. It's just how Bron shoots.
On 5 attempts.
It's just how Bron ain't finna catch and shoot it. He gotta
think about it. Look at it for 3 seconds.
He be having like a Raven Simone vision when he do that.
It's crazy that
you can
it's
tell when he about to shoot, bro.
It works.
It works so
people fall
so
for whatever. Well. He's gonna shoot it.
Yeah.
I've never seen him pass out of it or do it as a hezzy or nothing.
Remember the All-Star game? I forget what the pitcher it was, but he kind of was like, I gave Derek Jeter something to hit. Because Derek Jeter was old and at the end of his career. And Derek Jeter got to the press. I was like, I don't know why he do that. I don't even give me nothing to hit.
Mm-mm.
What are people doing that for Bron? they falling for the, because it's like, that's bro, I'm gonna just let it disappoint.
Oh,
I'm just playing. I would never, nah, I would never allege that on LeBron legacy. Which, like Scottie Pippen saying they giving Jordan his steals.
Hey, that article that Tom Haberstroh put together is for real? Yahoo Sports is crazy, bro. Like it made me rethink Michael Jordan, bro.
Uh-oh.
Did y'all see that stuff?
I haven't read it.
I was telling y'all like the differences between the homes, what was it, stocks?
Five
at home, three at, when he was on the road. And it's just like that stands out a lot.
So it used to be rumored that like John Stockton's assists were like like that. But then someone did the research and said, no, like there was no discrepancy between home and away for John Stockton. And Haberstroh and them was like, was there a discrepancy for Michael Jordan, DPOY?
They're the same thing with Triple J.
Was that proven?
I think the Grizzlies came out and they were like, man, no, these are the blocks that we were giving him. And they were trying to prove it. But I don't know if it all fully came out that they didn't do it at all. But I know there was the accusation on Triple J about like the blocks.
I remember the accusation.
Yeah. I don't know if it was fully true or they fully disproved it, whatever.
But the MJ thing is crazy.
Yeah,
because they went back to watch the footage. It was like a 6-game sample size of him being at home, and they actually watched the games, like not just looked at, like watched those games in its entirety, and they tallied themselves. Here's a block, here's a steal, here's a so one of those games. The team that they were going against hit 3 turnovers as a team, but he in the box score, Michael Jordan had 5 steals.
Oh wow. Shit,
dude, that don't even make sense.
And they said when they watched the footage in that game sample size, he had 12 real steals that they tallied themselves. Box score had him with 26. My GOAT! They saying he won't really like that.
Wait. The box score said he had 26
steals? And then the eye said he had 12.
He had 12 steals in the game?
That's no, in the 5-6 game samples.
Yeah. At first, it did sound like he was talking about in one
game. Yeah, that's what I thought. That's what it sounded
like. Once he said like 26.
My fault, that was Kevin Gill.
Like, once he said 26, I was like, it's got to be in a, like a game space. Yeah. Like
but that. In the games that they watch,
yeah.
They tallied him for over double the amount Damn. That he actually got.
That's actually kind of crazy.
And now it's like going to go down as the worst DPOY maybe ever.
I was going to say one of them DPOYs, you got to put them jewelry. That detector to it.
It just.
So, how about the NBA with all the money that they have, pay like a group of 5 people to just go back and watch everything? Somebody would do it.
If it was available, I'm sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
There's a LeBron super fan out there that's like, yeah, I watch every single one of them to prove that DPOY that y'all hang over LeBron because he didn't get, you know.
LeBron having a DPOY is still kind of crazy.
Yeah. It's not too late.
True.
Yes, it is.
It's a little too late.
He was finna say true.
All you gotta do is lock in.
Right. You know what I'm saying? He's still physically gifted. You saw him in the dunk contest with Obi Toppin.
Yeah, we were just talking about that's funny. That's good basketball talk. We went from rumors. Jimmy Butler, all his trades, a little Josh Richardson got some love, all the way to Michael Jordan lying. About, well, not him lying.
Yeah, he didn't come out and say it personally.
The team's lying. What are some other things that y'all think could have been manipulated?
I do think
Stockton assists, yeah. Jordan steals.
No, I was about to say, I do think it's crazy that Scottie Pippen is the one that addressed that.
Why do you think it's crazy?
It's just funny that he always got something to say.
Oh, yeah, Jordan that's why it ain't crazy, because that's low key his biggest hater.
Hakeem's blocks are crazy. Hakeem is head and shoulders over everybody. And it's just,
Where's the Kembe at on fake. That? If you're looking at, like, total blocks.
Let's see. All-time blocks.
Like, who's the top? I'm guessing Dwight's in there.
Hakeem
is
number one?
At the top over 600 more than Dikembe Mutombo at number 2.
Damn.
Dennis, Kareem, Mark Eaton, Tim Duncan, David Robinson, Patrick Ewing, Shaq, Tree Rollins, and Robert Parrish.
Uh-oh.
That's the top.
I thought Dwight was in the top 10.
Nope. He's number 13.
Oh.
Not too late to get into the top 10, Dwight. You guys
somebody just got to sign.
He's only 100 plus away. 2 good seasons.
I'm top 10?
Yeah. The only active player on this list is who? Top 25. Who's
LeBron.
The only active? No.
And blocks?
Yep. Only active player.
Anthony Davis?
No, he is 26, though.
Let me think.
So he's going to be 25
active
at the end of the season.
In blocks.
Mm-hmm.
And he's Brooke Lopez?
Yeah, it is Brook Lopez at 22 with 1,912 total blocks in his career so far. But he's got an opportunity to end up top 20.
How far is he?
About 100 and some change away from top 20.
Okay.
So a couple, a year and a half, maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
Depending on what the knee's doing, that back is doing. Any other rumors that's been catching y'all eye?
I just like the fact that the Houston Rockets are star hunting, they said. If they can find a way to get a Brandon Ingram, a Paul George. Ace mentioned Kevin Durant, Jimmy Butler, Mikal Bridges. They know what type of time that they own. So they out there trying to make something shake. Did the Knicks call for Jaren Jackson, I read?
Oh, I didn't hear that at all.
Jaren?
Yeah, somebody called around asking about Jaren Jackson.
Jaren's one of those dudes that's untouchable right now.
Yeah, that's what I heard. Mm-hmm. The Hawks, the only untouchable guy over there is Jalen Johnson Jr.
Yep.
That makes sense.
One of the things that I thought was just funny is when I seen the Pelicans, they called up the Rockets talking about, we want Shingun for Brandon Ingram.
Yeah, I saw that too.
I was like, y'all crazy.
Bro. There's just certain... As a GM, if I'm the Rockets, wouldn't I be offended?
Yeah, probably hung up the phone immediately.
Raphael Stone?
It's like when the Blazers asked for Bam or Jimmy Butler in the Damian Lillard
trade. Yeah.
It's like, what are you doing? What are you doing?
And then the argument is they can only say no, right? Or hang up the phone.
Yeah, you just ruin your whole relationship and never be able to trade with that team.
Because if I'm Pat Riley, I'm now offended that you just called me and asked me for Bam.
Because there are sometimes with GMs scratch each other's back, man. And you don't want to be the guy that's known as the dude that's trying to finesse. Unless you're just really, really good at it. And then you would think people just stop making deals with you, but they never really do.
Mitchell Robinson to Washington, I've been seeing.
They're going to have Alex Sarr.
Yeah, he played power forward.
Oh. Yeah.
That's a big-ass lineup.
Yeah, right? With Denny, Bilal, Kuzma's technically still over there.
Kuzma can't interaction to the Kings.
They really don't sleep on him. You said what?
I like that spot for him.
I mean, yeah. They got Harrison Barnes, Trey Lyles, two tradable contracts.
Kevin Herter. Porzingis will undergo surgery.
Yep, so he's going to miss.
Qualifying Olympic tournament for Latvia.
There was no way he was going to be able to play in the Olympics.
I wonder where his priorities are, because I know a lot of people say that especially the foreign-born players, playing for your home country is the most important thing in my basketball life. So I wonder how he feels about all of this. I mean, at the end of the day, it's not that he could have done about it. Like, it's an injury.
And it was one of the rarest injuries you could have as an athlete.
Man, Landry Fields on Alex Sarr. He was scheduled to come work out. We had it on the books, and then he declined to come work out.
Damn. Yeah, I seen that.
My man said,
that's just too crazy. Much going on over there.
Yeah. It is a lot of
too much uncertainty. Yeah.
But, like, at the same time, it seems like he at least gets to play with one of the guards, I would assume.
He also is playing a position. He's also probably trying to play a position that Jalen Johnson, who is untouchable, plays.
Oh, yeah.
You just don't know what the team's going to look like. At least with Washington, they're going to be bonds. Mm-hmm. They're going to give me an opportunity to play 25 to 30 minutes a night.
Yeah.
And Atlanta, who knows what their direction is? Do they still want to compete for a playoff spot? If so, then I might not be in the rotation as much as I want to because I'm raw.
League sources say the 39-year-old LeBron James has not given the Lakers any indication on what he will do, even if the widely held expectation around the league is that he will either return on his player option to sign a new deal. So, like, Mike, y'all over there still in the dark, bro.
I really think he's just going to opt out, and that doesn't leave out the Lakers, but he's just going to try to get a different deal instead of staying on that player option.
I don't blame him. I mean, it's LeBron James. He's going to get another 2+1 deal, as he always do. He do it at the end of every one of his contracts.
Mike Dunleavy.
I don't think he's ever taken a player option.
Mike Dunleavy Jr. and Klay Thompson. We want him back. I think we've said that all along because there's been rumors that Klay Thompson has not liked how they have handled the contract situation. As crazy as it is, if y'all was to see him leave, what is the one jersey y'all think y'all can picture him in y'all brain? Because, I mean, I can't picture him walking around in a Bulls red and white jersey.
I've seen the Philly ones do look up. I've seen the Philly ones where they, like, edited Bob in. It?
Yeah.
It's Philly or Orlando? Good.
Orlando just have a history of people getting there at the end of their careers. And it's like, damn, he played there? I don't want Klay Thompson to fit into that, bro. I just don't want him to fit into that.
Pistons Jazz expected to show interest in Tobias. You've been saying future Pistons Tobias Harris.
It's inevitable. Get ready to learn it again, Detroit.
So the Pistons' plan is to probably sign him, let him come in here, build up his stock, trade him for assets.
Or he just stays around. He'd still be one of the best players on the team.
A nice little vet there.
I guess.
I think Tobias Harris is hurt when there's expectation. I think if he goes to Detroit and everybody already written him off, nobody talking about him, there's nothing for him to really do. I don't think it really matters. But yeah. I think when you attach, how much money was he making?
40 million. Yeah. I think on that last year, he made $39 million
on an Eastern Conference team like the Philadelphia 76ers with expectations to get to the conference finals.
And score 0 points in a closeout game, making $40 million.
Yeah. You chop that 40 in half, he's at 19-21 on a Detroit Pistons. And I think the entire vibe of everything around his name changes. Valanciunas is linked to the Lakers. Is Anthony Davis a four, or is he staying at the five?
I don't know if Valanciunas is the answer, but I wouldn't mind picking up a big man that can have us have a really big lineup where Anthony Davis played a four, because I think with Sean to go against the Nuggets and also just going forward against these other bigger players, for Anthony Davis to be kind of like that backside guy and have a big body on these guys like a Jokic or whatever.
Valanciunas, so I wouldn't be mad at it. Dance.
Yeah, there was also, I don't know about Valanciunas.
That was also something I read that said y'all are still interested in DeJounte, mm-hmm. and if y'all can make that happen, y'all would love to include Clint Capella.
I wouldn't mind Clint Capella.
I just love AD at the five so much. I just think it just adds so much like freedom. Like when you have a center that can't really shoot, mm-hmm. and you have a four who can't really shoot in Anthony Davis, it just kind of just makes it all
that's
so
why
clunky.
It's not just for like a that's going to be the permanent lineup, but he playing 30 minutes a night. Yeah. It's more so very situational. And it's like Clint Capella, I'm okay with him if he's playing 20 minutes and Anthony Davis is playing the rest of that minutes at center. He's still going to be a lot at center.
Yeah.
It's just probably certain times, especially for defensive reasons, why you plug him in at that four. And honestly, he has a matchup advantage when he's at the four, too.
Yeah, he has at the four or the five.
Yeah. So,
what y'all tell me if y'all would do this. There's an idea that on Wednesday, the Rockets would trade number 3 to Memphis for 9 and Marcus Smart so the Grizzlies can draft Donovan Clingan.
So, I think that's a real possibility. I think that I was going to for drop the mic, and we could kind of go into it before we get into our mock draft, too. But it's like
before our break and then our mock draft.
But do y'all see teams moving down more so just to get win now players and try to, you know, get ready to compete? Or do you see teams more so moving up to get who they want?
Combination of both.
Uh-huh.
I see, like, yeah, the Grizzlies, if they can move
Grizzlies,
up.
Grizzlies, I think the team. Rockets are another team that probably, like, trade. Well, Grizzlies are a team, I think, trade up because they want. Donovan Clingan seems like he could be a Grizzly this year.
Yeah, and I'm mad your league froze. Bro. Because I drafted Donovan Clingan.
Yeah.
It did it again?
Yeah. Oh, he wasn't there. Yeah. Why am I thinking you in it? It did it again. We had a draft.
We didn't get to free agency. It was just in the draft. And it's just like, yeah. It was a good draft, too.
God, 2K is an awful draft.
Kyra had Topic and Salon.
Yeah.
To Jane Salon, yeah. And he didn't even draft them. CPU just gifted him. But, yeah, Rockets going down to 9 and getting Marcus Smart for the Grizzlies to get Clingan. That would be nice if they get him. Hawks could be like, we want him at 1.
Yeah.
Do something about it.
That's something you wait to see if he's still on the board. And if he is, then maybe pull the trigger. I don't know. I've just heard conflicted things about the Marcus Smart stuff. Like, I read something that they weren't thinking about trading him at all. And then also you see these type of things. So
yeah.
It's hard to think to trust any room at the moment, honestly.
For sure. The Grizzlies are hard because nobody really played outside of Jaren Jackson.
Yeah, I feel like their team is probably looking to just keep their assets and just see what it
The reason
looks like.
I say that, like, the Clingan just makes so much sense is because they literally got rid of Steven Adams last year.
Yeah, I don't think that there is a better fit in the entire draft than the Grizzlies getting him.
Yeah.
We're talking about a playoff team who needs a center. He just slides right in, won back-to-back championships. It's not me saying he's going to be the best player out of this draft or the best prospect ever, but like when you just talk about peer prospect and fit, I just don't see anything that is like better than that. So, yeah, we can go to our break. I'm ready to draft now.
Let's get to our break. When we come back, we will be drafting the 2024 class.
Why should you bet with Caesars Sportsbook? Two words, Caesars Rewards. Every bet brings you closer to the type of benefits only Caesars can offer. Hotel stays, VIP experiences, sports and concert tickets, and more. It's not just an app, it's an empire.
So we're going to keep it very simple. We're just going to go straight down the line.
We can't. I'm gonna tell you why. If we go straight down the line, whoever's four is gonna have the Spurs twice. So we gotta go down the line and then back down. How we do the draft.
When we was doing, when he said down the line, I thought he was talking about we were just gonna go straight one. Just we all gonna discuss who goes one, who goes two, who goes three.
Oh, I thought we was all gonna pick for each team.
No, everybody's picking for each team.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Who wants to get it started with the first pick though? Do we which end do we start on?
I'll start. Okay. So the Atlanta Hawks, I would have them taking Donovan Clingan. Actually, no.
You went to the podium and
hold
you
up.
Said, never
what?
Mind.
Now we going to say this.
What?
There ain't no hold up. I don't know if you ever watched the NBA draft, but ain't nobody ever ran down and said, no, Adam Silver, that ain't, no, we didn't mean him. You got the first damn pick. And you over here talking about, he the team that used the whole clock.
That's crazy.
Actually, I'll go Donovan Clingan. Yeah, I think they'll take him first.
Okay.
No.
What?
Let's do this. And it may not say that. Do what you want to do.
No, I know. I'm getting Donovan Clingan because I probably feel like I'm moving on from Clint Capella.
My boy.
Bring in a nice young center that can pair next to Jalen Johnson.
Perfect.
And I think that sets us up for the future.
Yeah, could just going to be a career backup?
I guess so.
I just want you to do you. It's going to be too hard. It's going to be too hard for us to think about what they want to do.
And it's not out the realm of possibility. It's been rumored that they're interested. So that's not a bad pick, I guess.
So at number two, I didn't want the second pick because now I have to take Alex Sarr. So we're going to take Alex Sarr with the Wizards. That's kind of boring. But
I just don't feel like Atlanta's going to draft him if he's not working.
They're not.
Out. Yeah.
They're not.
Unless they're going to try to flip him, which is a dangerous game to play. Yeah. Third overall pick. Houston Rockets, a team that I think is just going to be interested in trading this pick away.
Trade it.
Who's interested? Who wants to trade up to three?
So
do the Charlotte Hornets want to trade up to three?
Four. I'm the Hornets.
Let's talk.
What do you offer me?
I don't know. I just really like the idea of Reed Shepherd and Charlotte. That's really
I don't have any. Oh, we damn sure ain't taking Reed Shepherd.
Oh,
we want Stephon Castle.
Oh, no. He's not. No.
And we don't have no win now players. That y'all would want.
Sign to trade Miles Bridges.
Y'all don't want Miles Bridges.
Don't want Miles Bridges.
Y'all got him already. His name's Cam Whitmore. Well, let me not say that, Cam.
With the idea of them keeping it since nobody's calling my phone.
Nah, you keeping it.
We're gonna take
Reed Shepherd with the idea that him and Amen Thompson in 2 years are gonna be our backcourt.
I like that.
Okay. Y'all get
like
a pure sniper. Why not?
Okay.
Yeah.
Honestly, I didn't expect Zaccharie Risacher to still be up there, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab him with the fourth pick for the Spurs.
Risacher, say it again.
Risacher,
say Massachusetts.
Massachusetts.
Yeah, bro.
I was messing his name up a lot too.
Say it one more time.
Risacher.
I'm looking at the document,
at
the pronunciation.
Oh, yeah. Risacher.
I could still be wrong. But okay. So that means it's back on me at five?
Yep. Yeah.
There's so many different ways we can go as a Detroit Pistons.
He took Risacher
at four.
Yeah. At four. Okay. Oh, I hope they get him in real life.
That's a good pickup. If he falls there, that's huge for them.
They saying he could go one to the Hawks.
So we are the Detroit Pistons.
Mm-hmm.
And right now we kind of like a blank canvas. We just signed one of the best shooting coaches in basketball, so we can afford to maybe go get somebody that can't really shoot that well. We're going to go with a guy.
He already got his hands full with a star.
I guess
he do.
Matas Buzelis, welcome to Detroit, my guy.
Hey, I like it.
6'10", 197, 6'10", wingspan.
No, not too far from Chicago.
Yeah, you know, he's still local. We can still go play a round of golf with him.
We can.
A little travel.
We definitely can.
We like his upside as another guy that can be a little connector, get to the basket when necessary. Again, we don't have a lot of shooting here in Detroit, but we're going upside again for the 30th year in a row.
That was the fifth pick, right?
Correct.
Yep. So P is at
Charlotte Hornets.
Charlotte.
It's an easy pick for us. Another easy one. We're just gonna take Stephon Castle out of UConn, winning player. We have LaMelo, we have Brandon Miller, we have Mark Williams. We now just need connecting pieces. We need us to – we're going to take a mini Jrue Holiday who going to come in and defend, be able to cut with the ball, bring the ball up, initiate some offense, and we are big believers in his jump shot.
That's a big pick with D-Mills. D-Mills has his Blazers pick right now.
Yes, perfect.
For me, if I'm the Blazers in this situation, I'm going to take the wing with a lot of potential in Cody Williams. And I'm going to bring him in and pair him next. Because we already have a backcourt. We have a solidified backcourt already. We got Shaden Sharp. We have three guards. We got to find a wing. We got to draft a wing that we think we could develop and play at a high level. And I think Cody Williams can do that for us.
Okay. Not mad at that.
I love that pick, Derek. So it's on me at 8 with the Spurs.
Yep.
It's a lot of different directions we can go here.
We just got Zach.
We got Zaccharie Risacher. Nikola Topic has an ACL injury that's kind of scaring us off. So we're probably going to stay away from that. We really like Rob Dillingham, but this is the Spurs. So, you know, we're going to shake up the draft a little bit.
Uh-oh.
And we are going to take Devin Carter from Providence.
Oh, yes. Ooh. Let's go.
We want winning players.
I could definitely see the Spurs being one of those teams that could just take a reach. I could definitely see it.
We got a guy that we don't care about what mocks are saying. We don't care what the big boards are saying. We brought him in. We like him a lot. He's going to come in, and we don't have to worry about him fitting.
Yeah.
He's going to find a way to be successful.
I like that. Very good pick.
We as the Memphis Grizzlies are pissed off that Donovan went first overall because we could not even get in the conversation to trade up to one. So now we have to pivot. The next center on the list on the big board is like Zach Edey. I don't think we're really interested in that. And number 9.
I don't blame you.
So we're going to redirect ourselves to someone else. Anybody want to call up to trade for this pick? Because we really want to cling in or nothing. So we'd be okay with flipping this pick.
Damn.
So you're the Grizzlies.
D-Mills messed up your draft.
Yes, you are U10.
Yeah, I'm Jazz.
The Jazz. I mean U11, the Bulls.
Yeah.
I'm 12 at OKC. I think you got a draft. Grizzlies.
I just feel like we got bit with the Zaire Williams.
I'm at Sacramento
thing.
Kings.
They don't want to trade up.
Yeah, we got bit with the Zaire Williams thing. So, like, Ron Holland kind of makes sense, but damn it, we tried that already.
Try it again.
We are going to take one of the safer picks in this draft. I feel like, no, I don't like this. I don't like this.
Can you? Come on.
Who was the safe pick?
Come on.
I'm saying that's left on the board.
The Silva?
No.
This is probably what it's like to be in a GM in that war room.
We're gonna take Ron Holland.
There we go. I like that.
But you hear how excited I am about it?
No.
We're going to take Ron Holland.
This just sounds like I will just take him.
Just take him. Maybe he turns
your
into...
Your time was going down. Your time was almost up.
We panicked. We took Hashim to beat.
I got the Jazz on the clock at 10. And honestly, I don't really...
He took your pick.
Oh,
you can trade for him.
No, it's okay.
Loud and marketing.
Walker Kessler for that ninth pick, and you could have back-to-back picks.
Talk to me. Yeah. You said Walker Kessler was available. We trade Ron Holland for Walker Kessler right now, if that was your prospect number one on your board.
Nah, we looking for a center for Walker Kessler, starting caliber center. We about to draft. You know, we not trying to help you out, bro. We good.
Okay.
It's fine.
With no true direction, I feel like we got time. We going to take Nikola Topic. I know he got his injury.
Yes.
We
advantage. Because who cares about Keontae George being on that roster having a good rookie year? Go get another guard to make him. No, I'm just joking. That's still a good pick, though.
So it's me at 11?
With the Chicago
This is actually
Bulls.
Working out perfectly. There's so many different ways. There are people on the board right now that I would have loved to see in Chicago. No, that's not true. He got picked up a while ago. So we're gonna say, hey, Vucevic, count your fucking days, man.
Take my guy. Come on.
We're going to take Khalil Ware.
Yes.
With the 11th overall pick.
Hey, when I do my Bulls rebuild, that's what we taking, y'all.
Khalil Ware with the 11th overall pick.
Okay,
you want to know why?
Okay, he jumping up.
You want to know why? And yes, this is not where he's projected to go. But in a draft like this, you go
that's
get
okay.
your guy.
Yeah, you go get your guy.
And there are some guys on the list that like I would like to see in Chicago if we didn't just trade for a point guard or another guard. So we're going to go with a position of need, a guy with a lot of upside that, you know, he showed some shooting flashes at Indiana last season. We questioned his motor, but I feel like there's a lot of centers in recent draft history that his motor was questioned and he came to the league and you ain't questioning it no more. Mm-hmm. Khalil Ware, welcome to Chicago. Can't wear that number, though. Damn near retire.
So.
Number one?
Yeah.
I am OKC. We took Khalil Ware. We have Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. We just got Caruso. We got J-Dub. We got Chet. Who else they got on it?
Isaiah Joe.
Lou Dort.
They got good guards.
They don't really have a big wing.
We gonna look to shake the draft up some more. We seeing guys reaching, going early. We've done a good job. We feel like we can get a big in the offseason. We got some money, so we feel like we can get us a Drummond or a Valanciunas if we need to. So what we gonna do is we gonna take up the fact that y'all just out here slipping. And we're gonna take Dalton Connect.
Damn.
That's a good pick. Yeah, that's a really good pick. That's a really good pick.
We got Isaiah Joe and Dalton Connect coming off the bench.
I thought that was gonna fall right to the Kings. I was like, Dalton Connect is the guy.
The Kings guys right still right there.
Yeah, what you mean? The perfect dude.
Who?
You don't know I can't help.
Right, that's calling the other GM.
Was Stephon Castle drafted already?
Hell yeah. Yes.
Okay, I didn't remember hearing his name. I was just curious. I just didn't remember hearing it.
What position the guy you thinking of?
He is 6'2".
He's what?
A 6'2". Oh. Like a guard.
Yeah,
we thinking
of two different people.
Oh.
I'm thinking of a guard, but he ain't 6'4".
For me, if I'm the Kings in this situation, I'm gonna take Jacoby Walter.
Okay. Is that who you were thinking of, Mike?
Yeah, it was.
They can come in, shoot the ball well, catch and shoot threes are phenomenal.
I think they're going to get another guard.
Jerry McCain is a guard.
No, I'm talking about, like, no. Oh, we were like, both right. Yeah. Like, I instead of, there's forwards up there they could get, like, but I think they're going to trade for a forward. They obviously got some bonus. I think they're going to go for another guard. They don't know. I mean, Davion Mitchell, I don't think he's, like, a staple for them at all. Like, I think they're able to move on for him, though.
So, it's on me at 14 with Portland. Yep. You took Cody Williams?
Yes, I did.
So they have Scoot, Anthony, Shaden, Cody, Jeremy, Robert Williams, DeAndre Ayton. This is the most loaded non-winning team ever.
Don't forget Chris Murray's on that team, too.
Chris Murray, lefty. So looking at the draft board, we got some interesting things going on. I think again, we are in a position to just reach. You already took a wing. We got a boatload of guards. We are going to take.
Get another wing.
No, we're going to take a big.
Oh.
No, we're not. Because we're going to take Tyler Smith out of the G League Ignite. We're going to take a shot on a guy who we think has some scoring prowess at the four, because we're almost certain that we're going to move on from Jeremy Grant.
Okay.
We're going to bring in Tyler Smith, who's going to get some buckets for us with the lefty. Yuck.
That's a nice pick right there. That was a deep pick. I think definitely like a fit pick right there.
A fit pick?
Yeah.
Okay.
Not the one on Instagram, though.
Okay. Us is the Miami Heat. I'm just going to do it. Zach Edey. Welcome to Miami.
Wow.
Bam, yeah. Slide over.
That is not a Miami pick.
Slide over.
That's not a Miami.
It is time.
You just saw, every Heat fan is, they're hating you right now.
They like, we just had Jerry McCain
they'll
in our lap.
I promise you that.
We had a real guard.
They'll be all right.
We tired of seeing Hero at the one.
Yeah. With the 76ers on the clock, 16 pick, I'm going to take Rob Dillingham. Campaign.
Oh, the Heat could have got Rob Dillingham.
Failed that
I'm fall. Taking Rob Dillingham campaign. You had some big little moments, but come on now. We got a new guard in town.
I kind of forgot he was on the board, no lie. I just felt like he got drafted already.
You better make the right pick, too.
Do you want this pick? Because it is your pick. Because all of us have drafted for our favorite team. No, I mean, just like you just be the Lakers, so you get back-to-back picks.
Sure, yeah.
Time I make the right pick. Now let's see what you do.
Right.
Oh, well, it's right there for you.
What you mean?
I can't help you, but I'm looking right at the guy.
There's one guy that is still falling that I'm surprised has not been selected yet. But I don't know if the Lakers make sense.
There's a couple players that I wouldn't mind on the Lakers. I do like Kyshawn George because he shot the ball well.
If you don't pick this dude, I'm busting your head.
Let me get Tristan De Silva.
I'm busting your head.
Who you? Well, I guess he'll got to say.
Jared McCain. He was going to be able to catch and shoot that ball from day one.
He would.
And he a dookie.
Does that mean I'm Orlando now at 18?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sheesh. I mean, this guy's just still falling down the board that, like, even if he don't fit, he's got to get selected somewhere, and it's an upside pick. We're going to take Trijan Salon.
Yeah.
At 18, I mean, yeah, he's another wing to add to this team with a million wings, but
hey, switch your thing.
If he's just there, just sitting, we'll make it work, or we won't.
19, I am the Toronto Raptors. So we have Quickly, we got Bear, we got Scotty Barnes, we got Pirtle. We just got to get talent. We're going to take Jared McCain because y'all just letting him fall. We're going to take Jared McCain.
You already got Jared McCain.
Yeah. Welcome to Toronto.
Cleveland, your favorite city, D-Mills.
Oh, man.
He going to sell on purpose.
Cleveland?
He talking about LeBron James.
So, for them, they've really struggled at that wing position. Damn, Mike took him. Fuck. I just realized that.
Who?
Tristan Da Silva.
What are you looking for, a wing?
Yeah.
It's so many. So many.
Just trying to, I'm looking through my list.
I need some shooting over there.
Yeah, so for them, since they are in a compete, I think they can take a reach on a guy. I'm going to get him Kyshawn George. Think he can come in and really fit at that three spot and shoot the three ball well. Not a guy that needs the ball a lot in order to shoot the ball at a high clip.
21st, New Orleans.
Kyshawn George, by the way.
Kyshawn, my bad.
Who? The Pelicans?
Yeah.
There's so many different ways we can go. The guy that I think would be perfect for them is already taken. They are going to take a chance on somebody. We're going to take a chance because the Pelicans got a lot of. They got a lot of guys who can do things, so we can take chances. We're gonna take
Don't take him.
We're gonna take Isaiah Collier.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Look her, but I'm not expecting that at all.
Who am I again?
The Suns.
Yeah, at for the Suns, we're gonna take Eve Misi.
Yes.
That's a good pick. Clint
Capella 2.0.
I thought I was gonna pick too.
I think that's literally what I put his player comp as is Clint Capella.
The Bucks.
With the Bucks, we want a dude that's going to sit down in that chair and defend for us. Give us Ryan Dunn.
Oh.
You got him already in Andre Jackson.
Damn,
take another one.
I mean, well, Ryan Dunn is going to be an even better defender. But
Who are we, the Knicks?
Take him away from him. I don't want Ryan Dunn to go to the
Knicks. I cannot believe one of these guys is still on the board, but he doesn't fit here.
Who?
The first Knicks pick, because you get the second one. Dayron Holmes, welcome to New York.
Oh, that's
a good pick.
That's a Thibodeau pick. Thibodeau going to love him some Dayron Holmes, bro.
You're going to move Mitchell Robinson for something. I don't know. Maybe it's another
draft. Now you got
Isaiah
Hartenstein starting, and then you got Dayron Holmes coming off the bench.
And we still got Precious Achiuwa.
Yeah, they'll figure it out.
With our next pick in New York, we're going to take another guy Tom Thibodeau would love. That's Jalen Tyson out of Cal. My boy.
I was hoping he failed.
Welcome
me.
To the Big Apple, my boy.
All right, so I'm the Washington Wizards. I was really hoping to get Jalen Tyson. I don't know why.
Jalen is crazy.
Dude, right here is where.
This dude's going to fall out the first round?
Who?
I'm not going to say. But Washington should be thinking about him. Unless he'd been drafted when I wasn't paying attention.
Did y'all take Carlton Carrington?
No, that's what I'm thinking about.
Oh, yeah.
Draft Bub for Washington, please. Please draft him.
Bub. I know who you're talking about.
He's looking for Bub. He's looking for Bub.
You know who I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
What college you went to?
I forgot.
Oh, let me not ask you that because.
Oh, you should have just responded with the JJ Redick thing.
No, I'm gonna take Carlton Carrington.
Okay, cool.
That's Bub.
Yeah, it is. I forgot. That's his. Yes, I know. I was really looking at that yesterday.
That's a good pick. If he's there at 26, yeah. Come on, that's a steal.
I got him. I wrote in there. He's a professional scorer already at 18.
Yeah,
I am.
Same that wrote for GG Jacks.
Minnesota Timberwolves.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, let's get it. Who you giving him?
I see a dude up there.
They have Nasri, Rudy, Cat, Jaden McDaniels, Nikhil Alexander Walker. They need somebody.
Kyle Anderson might be up though, isn't he? Yeah, is he a free agent?
I don't know if he is, but I don't know how long he's going to be in Minnesota.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking at Kevin McCullough from Kansas, and I'm also looking at Dylan Jones from Weber State. And I'm gonna give him Dylan Jones from Weber State. Do it all guy.
Next pick is the Denver Nuggets, yeah. We're gonna take Kyle Filipowski. He said he watched a bunch of Jokic film. Now he can play with Jokic.
I have the Jazz back up on the clock. I'm gonna go with Johnny Furpy to help us space the floor and shoot the ball.
Furpy?
What'd I say?
Furpy.
Oh. Furpy.
And this is the last pick, the first round.
They got another tall white man shooter.
The Boston Celtics are gonna select they're gonna select Terrence Shannon.
I like
from
that.
Illinois.
I like that.
Ugh. All right. Not doing second round, obviously.
What his playing time going to come in there?
It's the Celtics. No matter who they draft at 30, he's going to be playing time.
They do only legit have like an 8-man rotation.
Best players available for the second round, though.
My boy, Pacome. Daddy A.
My boy, Baylor Schirmeyer.
Bobby Clement. P.J. Hall would have been good for the Celtics. Trenton Flowers. There's some guys back here.
Yeah.
Jalen Bridges.
Well, they got to wait until tomorrow because it's a two-day event now.
Cam Christie.
Bronny. Nobody thought about Bronny.
I was letting the Lakers get him at 17. Tristan Newton. What up, Brody?
I should just draft him at 30. Why not? Bronny, welcome to some winning. Something. Never mind.
Didn't your boy Simmons say that?
Draft him and then hold him hostage or something?
Yes.
Yeah, it's crazy.
That was a good draft, man.
I don't think it was that many, if any, like, what the hell moments in the draft. I was hoping for.
Yeah, it wasn't too many. I think some of the what the hells is Jerry McCain falling.
Bob Carrington fell to 26.
Yeah, that was.
The Silver fell. My bad.
Somebody's going to end up falling, though. It's inevitable. Somebody's going every year.
Every year someone falls. So yeah. It just happens.
Could be somebody that we like or we met. But
the Devin Carter pick to the Spurs was.
Who they
it wasn't what the hell one, but it was
they
like
got
that
Devin
was
Carter
good.
And who else? Yes.
Richard Shea.
Good draft. Zach. That's a very good draft for them.
Yeah.
Good draft.
We would know how to pronounce his name if he was at the combine, did our interview.
Yeah.
He was still overseas hooping, though.
Should be fun, though. Tomorrow should be fun. Obviously, ours didn't have any trades, which I think that we will see a lot of trades tomorrow.
If it was more mapped out, we would have traded. But because I had to, in my mind, say, okay, who I'm going to have after these four picks, I couldn't really make no trade with you. But, yeah, it's kind of crazy that the draft is actually tomorrow.
Yeah.
The NBA Finals was last week,
so
right?
It feels like a week and a half ago. And then what happens? Free agency is in – isn't free agency July 1st?
Yeah.
Last weekend?
Yeah, it's July 1st.
So free agency's in a week from now.
Then we'll be in Vegas.
Right after summer.
Houston, land of Vegas.
June 30th is free agency.
Right, because it's at the night.
Yeah. 5 p.m. our time. It's so weird. But sure, we'll take it though. So yeah, this is a crazy week in basketball. Then we get a weekend of more basketball for Summer League, and then
before you know it, 2K dropping.
No, then the Olympics.
Not worried, but then the Olympics. So we gonna have hoops, man.
Are they gonna have the Olympic teams in 2K? They should, right? They should. They should.
I don't know if they'll have the rights though.
Somebody asked me, I forgot who it was. Like, man, when y'all in Vegas, y'all doing y'all face scan? I'm like, what?
They do that.
It was Kobe. He's like, yeah, when
like the face scans for 2K.
Yeah, I'm like, we are not in the game, brother. I appreciate you thinking about us like that, but we are not in the game.
They need
brother.
To have us in there where you just stop at the studio and do a little quick podcast.
You about to get drafted. You got me in there talking about, man, I remember watching you in high school. Look at you now. D-Mill's like, so what's your favorite snack between games? You like a salty snack or a sweet one? Because me personally, I love a big beef dipped extra mozz with a cheese fry on the side. And Mike over there like, I forgot what I was going to ask because I can't find my vape.
Do we have unplugged?
Y'all in the mood for unplugged? Y'all want to get it?
Yeah, I'm with whatever.
The rain make the mood seem so mellow. What type of mood y'all in for unplugged? Y'all want to have some
I'm
laugh?
Awake now.
Huh?
I'm awake now.
Now? Oh, I hope so. Yeah, work.
He's just sleeping over there.
Y'all want a goofy one, a funny one, or a nostalgic unplugged?
Goofy.
Goofy? What is the silliest thing? What is the silliest rumor you heard about yourself in high school?
It wasn't even a high school. It was a middle school that I did a hot dog, that I signed up to do a hot dog eating contest.
I remember that.
That it was like a talent show, and I signed up to eat the most hot dogs or something like that.
That wasn't a rumor. Somebody put your name in there.
Yeah, I know.
Who put your name there?
I don't know.
Never found out.
How many glizzies did you eat?
I never went. I didn't sign myself up. So I was just...
How many do you think you could eat? And it's in a... How long are hot dog eating contests? I'm going to look.
Google Kobayashi. Joey Chestnut.
There's no way I'm taking that. Like, they be doing two at a time. I can't take two. There's no way.
He put it to his mouth. He just put it to his mouth.
What?
And said they be doing two at a time.
They do.
How they be doing it?
and it's a 10-minute contest. How many hot dogs do you get down in 10 minutes?
Show us your technique. Because Kobayashi and Joey Chestnut be breaking them down with water. That's the most disgusting thing. Dipping your hot dog in water.
They make the bun all soft.
Oh, so you know about the technique.
No. I could probably only do 10.
One a minute?
Cause if you're trying, you can only do 10?
There's no way I'm chewing fast enough to eat that. One hot dog that fast.
You ain't never brother, I can. I know you could eat a hot dog in quicker than a minute.
Yeah, I was gonna say I've slammed a hot dog in like 30 seconds before.
We went to a baseball game and you ate one in line waiting for other food. Tell me I'm lying.
I probably have done that before.
Tell me
those
I'm lying.
Lines do be longer than.
Tell
a minute,
me
though.
I'm lying.
You're not.
I don't think there's nobody that's ever like that hasn't made a snack while also cooking some food before too. I know that's not the exact same.
No, but that's a snack. He ate a whole. Real
you gotta
food.
Remember, they don't have any condiments on it. It's not like you got peppers or relish. It's really just a dog and a bun.
The nacho helmet he was waiting for, or no, his Italian beef he was waiting for, and he ate his bratwurst
while waiting in line.
While waiting in line for it,
I could probably do 20.
Well, he had already had a nacho helmet, so he can't say it was hug. We go up there. I was like, let me give me some nachos. She like, what you want? I'm like, just give me the jalapenos, some chips, and the cheese. He behind me. She said, what you want on yours, huh? The kitchen sink.
What did he say when we were leaving Indiana? He said, this morning I got some Chick-fil-A. But right before we left, I also got a big beef. And we was leaving out at like 11 in the morning.
it wasn't even noon yet. He had a big beef and a burrito. Talking about, ooh, my stomach hurt a little bit. I wonder why. I wonder why.
I didn't even say my stomach.
I wonder why.
We really left at like 10:30.
We did.
And that one we had that a
I
big
think we left at 10:30.
We left at like before noon for sure. If we ain't
leave
at 10:30.
I think it was like
11:30. Something like that.
Yeah.
A beef before 12 is crazy. Was it a hit?
It was.
Now, what's the craziest? I don't even want. How do I? What's the craziest like exaggeration you made about yourself? Like, just say you're trying to get a girl, and what's something you saw?
I've exaggerated.
Yeah, nothing. I know you had. No, you exaggerate so many stories that you cannot look at me in my face.
When I'm talking to girls, I'm very much like, here's what you're going
to
get.
When you were talking to girls.
And when you were talking to girls. No, I'm saying that's how I approach it. Like, this, here's me. Here's what you're going to get. And whether you like it or not, we can either go separate ways. Or
no.
When you start talking to someone, you got to be so blunt and like you got to be so honest because like you don't want to catch them by surprise.
You would never tell Angie, I play the game. That's just what it is.
What you mean? If I'm a gamer, yeah. I'm not a gamer, so I wouldn't say that. So, like, it doesn't really fit. Like, I feel like with girls, I'm way more straightforward because I don't want to catch them by surprise.
Okay.
I don't really exaggerate anything.
What's something that you're extremely straightforward about or have been?
That I'm very laid back and I'm not really, like, I'm not going to be, like, that leader man that you might want me to be. I'm just going to be like, I'm just kind of go with the flow type of guy.
I see what you mean. At first, it came off crazy. Like, I want you to lead me.
Some girls want like that man is going to come in and lead and be like dominant. And like, I'm just like, we can go with the flow.
If you hear a noise in the night, are you checking it out or is she going to
He basically says she could check it out. No. He ain't no leader.
That's different. That's protecting your family.
I'm just talking about
day-to-day stuff. Like, am I wrong?
What? was you wrong about what?
You don't need our validation?
Yeah, I'm just saying.
I mean, first and foremost, he's absolutely correct. You're not wrong in how you live your life at all.
I'm just very
if you're not a leader, then you're not a leader.
Yeah.
What would be worse if you was trying to be a leader knowing damn well you're not? Yeah. But I think Mike did ask a great question. If you heard something and you need to go check it, are you turning into a leader then? Or are you like, babe, go first?
No, like if I hear a window bust, yes, I'm going to get up. Most times if I hear noises.
What do you do in that situation?
If I hear a window bust, mm-hmm. I get up. First, I check on wifey and my daughter. And then I go see who in the house or what's, if that person actually.
When you going, do you grab anything?
Yeah, you're just going to see, hey, who is that busting in my house? Hold on, let me go get some
usually
real quick.
You got like the golf. Unless you got your strap, you usually have like a golf club, a bat, or something just like right there.
You have anything in your room that's ready for that?
No, not really.
Oh, okay.
Put some under that bed.
Because I got some shit that's ready for
that. Put some under that bed, boy. A bat.
I got
golf, a bat. One of the clubs from your bat.
I got
a bat,
and I got the spikes wrapped around it.
I know he lying now. Yeah. I got some shit that I can find in the dark. It's posted right in a nice spot.
I don't blame.
I could do this, look around the corner and grab it. And you know what it sound like when it hit them?
Like a home run.
Fuck! No, I'll just play. It sound like a home run.
You should get bear mace.
That wouldn't be bad.
Bear mace,
but that also
watch out, babe.
I feel like that can also have like a recoil type of thing.
Yeah, but if somebody's broken into my house, I'll be okay.
When you lived in your apartment, you were on second floor, right? Out of like three floors?
It was only two floors.
No, it was three floors.
Huh. Did you ever hear the people above you often?
Never.
Bro, it's not bad because I know it's them, but a lot of time when I be laying down or like I'll be in the shower, I can hear them upstairs and it's like, it sounds like it's in my apartment, but it's just upstairs or whatever. They be throwing me off.
You know, the thing I hear the most is the closet door when it slides, like zoom. Mm-hmm. I hear that a lot. But
a lot of, when you have a cat, you naturally just hear noises throughout the night sometimes. So like you have to learn to differentiate. Like you might hear a random boom.
And if I'm the just cat like, get up, you getting up?
If the cat get up.
If the cat hear a noise and it gets up, are you getting up with it?
He's not a leader.
Wait, what does that mean?
Usually if the cat hears a noise and just like goes back, it's probably nothing. But if it's something that he gets up for and it's like, what is that? It could be something. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
That's dogs like, alarm systems.
Yeah. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah.
Well, Jackson my dog Cobra going to be barking if something happens.
And she look around, like I take her out at night and she, other day she.
Do y'all animals ever just look at the door, look at something, just stare at it?
Like if someone's in the hallway, they look or whatever.
Yeah.
I would definitely know because like my dog would probably start barking if someone was trying to come.
That's why I'm glad my dog is getting older because when she was
like even younger than what she is.
Yeah.
She had me on pins and needles and her ass looking around because the wind blew. Just scary.
Did I tell you, they said that cats can basically like hear your footsteps and distinguish them. So like if you walking down the hallway coming home or walking outside, they can kind of hear it.
They can hear you from a little far away too.
I seen somebody say that like basically they were on their way driving home from work and their significant other was at home with the cat. And the cat could hear the engine of the car, like it was a motorcycle on the highway from like a mile away or whatever.
Yeah.
And the cat already knew, like he was recording the cat. Yeah, it was getting up. It went from like laying down to getting up to sitting by the door, from like when he was like 5-10 minutes away.
Yeah, my cat greets me at the door all the time.
Can we distinguish something? He was telling Smalls about the laser. What is the laser not good for the cat and why? Because we was kind of like, yeah.
I forgot what it was. I had saw it somewhere, but like I don't remember what's wrong. Maybe it's like getting in their eyes. Like it helps.
That was my theory, but it's not like Smalls literally got the same thing that I showed. I showed the Discord and like 2-3 people was like, I'm going to get that for my cat. And he was saying that his cat likes it. And the only thing similar to me is like it could get in their eye, but it just don't be. Oh, yeah. It's not like they're just looking at it. They're kind of looking for the thing on the ground as it moves around.
Yeah, I think it was more so like their vision, like it could hurt their eyes.
But I'm gonna ask you the question I asked him: what's the craziest rumor you heard about yourself?
I had slept with somebody I didn't in high school. I didn't even lose my virginity until after high school.
Until yesterday.
Until after high school. So
he said, "How? How that happened? I didn't lose my virginity until I was 27." What's the craziest thing you ever exaggerated about yourself? Have you ever exaggerated your height to somebody? Have you ever catfished somebody? Have y'all ever catfished somebody?
No.
I mean, I joke about my height, but like.
Oh, you're joking.
It's in a sarcastic way. Like, we doing a little video, KB be like, what's your height? I'll be like 6'5". You know what I'm saying? No, but most people know I'm not 6'5".
No. What's something you exaggerated yourself about to like a woman that you were pursuing or, you know? Even if it was like some teenage stupid stuff.
I don't really feel like I exaggerate as much because I'm so laid back. I feel like a lot of people just know what they're kind of getting. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, you just that dude. They just know.
No, I don't know. I just never felt like, I felt like it was kind of cringy to just kind of flex for girls or whatever. Just because it's like, especially if you're flexing and that's not you. Like eventually they always say like, you can only hide it for 90 days or whatever before all this stuff comes out and everything like that. So I never really thought like flexing them for girls was especially. And also, only I didn't really talk to that many girls in high school either, like in a serious way. You know?
Exactly. That's why most teenage boys flex, because you're not going to talk to them for more than 90 days sometimes.
Let me think.
I only flex for the boys.
True.
I mean, I had that one time where I was talking to a grown woman and I was in high school and I told her I was.
See, that's what. I'm not even trying to bring him up, but like when I think of exaggerating or like just kind of like going like that, is when he told the lady that he worked at like
an airport. Like he worked at an airport. I was an engineer.
I feel like I've done something like that.
It happens. It happens. You know how many times I was young and broke and I was telling somebody I got money?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I don't even know why I did that.
Yeah, who hasn't done that before? Yeah, I'm thumbing through a check. Hey, Ma, you got $15. Who ain't done it as a young dude?
I had to like switch my whole mode. I had to try to act like an adult.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah,
she was telling me about her husband and his problems, and I was trying to be mature and talk.
That's the exact type of shit I'm asking. Yeah, that type of shit.
Because like, I looked older when I was in high school, so I was able to do that.
Exactly. That's exactly the type of shit I was saying.
I've never gotten with an older woman, but like. DM.
What happened? Did she ever find out? Or
I think she found out from like me making a post or something.
He made a post and he was in school. He was in the classroom.
Didn't think things through, huh, pal?
It wasn't that deep for me.
But I couldn't tell. I forget a whole new career as a kid. He came up with his whole. I would not have thought that deep
said
into
he
it.
Fixed planes. That was the career. I'm a plane fixer.
I would have lied about some dumb shit. I'm a rapper.
That wouldn't have worked though. She wanted somebody in a real career.
No, yeah, so definitely said, wouldn't have worked because I was
a plane engineer. Sounds like you got money.
You do. They make good money. Cost a lot of money.
So what made you think of that?
Because I wanted to work on planes.
And so when she asked you, so what type of stuff was she asking you about like the job?
Nothing really.
So just took it at face value.
Yeah.
What's back? Oh, today was a rough day. I had the Rotem and then the Atuberator was mixed together.
What was the most difficult thing to be mature about? And when you say I had to act mature, what were some of the things you had to be like, man, damn? Because I know you got them texts, like, you thinking like, damn, how I approach this?
He had the group chat. We all working together right. to be one adult.
He texting like, damn, man, these bills just keep hitting me.
I think it was just more so her going through that issues with her husband.
She was venting to you?
That's a skit. Over his shoulder, he typing, what you wearing right now? Then he like, nah, that's the immature me. How was work today? Your mom home? Oh, y'all, she probably live by herself. She grown. She grown. What's your plans for this weekend? That's a good one. I don't have nothing to top that. Talking to a grown woman as a kid, pretending to be. I did that before, but like on MySpace, and I definitely did not hide that I was a kid. You could tell. I probably thought I was, but I'm sure she knew I was a kid.
She just like, look at this.
She was just messaging back to probably entertain herself, or just be like, look, but I definitely wasn't.
You sound like a victim.
I was definitely like, it was like MySpace. I ain't know. Can you talk to me? She told me she would have flew me out. Let me stop. KB.
Nothing. I had the most boring everything.
You didn't exaggerate nothing to her?
That's a lie.
Mm-mm. I swear I didn't.
Nothing.
Nothing I could think of, no.
You ain't say, wait till you see. I was lying when I texted you. Because
I was about it.
What's the craziest room you ever heard about yourself?
Nothing, bro. I had seven friends, and we all still together. Like, I never even ventured out to get into rumors. It's really it.
He didn't get into rumors to rumor mills.
Right. It was the first time I heard the word.
That's because he was started. No.
First time I heard the word
he
rumors.
He the one that started that rumor about you.
was when Waka dropped that song.
Oh, rumors?
Yeah. Said they killed me and kidnapped. We had some crazy rumors in high school. Yeah. The girls always got the craziest rumors.
Yeah. And it spreads like wildfire.
It does. That's the funniest thing about high school. Yeah. You literally can make up stuff. Like the mic thing. You can make up some stuff and it'll grow legs like that.
Clingan gossip.
I'd never exaggerated for a girl or woman. It was always for the dude.
For what?
Other dudes.
What?
Let me explain.
To be cool? To seem cooler?
Seem cooler.
Like what? Like, I be smoking all the time.
Yes.
Smoking once.
And that happened. I had never smoked before. And then I became a smoker. You know what I'm saying? And then the other one was like.
Yeah, I love Granddaddy Kush Perk. What Lil Wayne be saying? What's the Lil Wayne lyric?
It's like when you in high school, you just lie about your virginity.
Shit. Yeah.
Man, stop playing. And that happened a lot. Where, like, I remember being at a party and one of the guys that I was hanging out with was like, yo, bro, you got a condom? I'm like, yeah. And I had one because that was the one that you have just in case. And
it was little.
Yeah, it was a, oh my God.
It was a lifestyle.
I don't know condom brands, you know what I'm saying? but it was a lifestyle. And I gave him the lifestyle. I remember looking at it like,
yeah. First of all, I'm good, bro. It's funny, if somebody who don't have one, you can't be picky, you just gotta take it.
I mean, if it's a lot, if you can't do a lifestyle, you can't do a lifestyle.
He was fronting his move, talking about looking at it.
Yeah.
Because y'all were probably 16, he telling us something.
I was like 15. I definitely was still a virgin then.
My mama, one time, walked in my room. My mama just had him in my room. She was just like, here.
Seemed like good parenting to me.
In case you need one.
Your mama thought highly of you.
That sound like off of Love Don't Cost a Thing. When his daddy had gave him all that condoms, and he was like, I'll get you some more. He's like, I still got the same one.
That's funny, though. Yeah. That's definitely one. Definitely exaggerate that. For sure.
You saying you don't have anything?
Who, me?
Yeah.
No.
Oh. What's the one thing you've exaggerated?
I told you. You know how many times I've been young and broke and act like That was a time where the very first time I went to Miami, I was with my brother, and I went on my brother's behalf. He was taking care of everything. And we was going to these clubs, doing extravagant shit. And, yeah, I was just making it seem like I had money that I didn't have. Oh. We was renting cars and shit. That's your car? Yeah. it's a Rolls Royce. Talking about, yeah, I ain't even had money to put no gas in there. Talking about, yeah, it's mine.
Yeah.
Hop in. just shit like that. Yeah, just over exaggerating anything. And I feel like the question for me would be, what didn't I over exaggerate in high school? What didn't I over exaggerate?
Yeah, I can't think of
anything. I never lied.
Yeah.
But I'm definitely over exaggerating. How many girls are you talking to? One of several. Anything. How many shoes you got? 30. You just exaggerate everything. Yeah. How much money you got? $5. I got a little stack on me.
My biggest lie in high school had to be that I got my homework done or that I left it at home.
Oh, yeah.
That was a weak ass lie. That was a weak ass lie.
Definitely didn't say it, though. I've said it.
Definitely looked through my book bag. No teacher ever was like,
he telling the truth. Right. Yeah, he did leave it at home.
I'm trying to think of a specific over exaggeration. I remember one time
my dog
did light up
my folder and had my homework in it. So I had to use that excuse that my dog ate my homework.
What the fuck you think you are, Bart Simpson?
Yeah, I don't know.
Does Aaron Yeager sit there? Has he been
up? No, somebody put him there.
Okay, because that has been throwing me off all episode. That he's just
Austin, you put him up there?
Overlooking us this whole episode.
Yeah, see, yeah.
We need some friends or something.
I'll bring some up there.
Somebody dropped him.
He's prone to commit genocide.
Take him back home. He ain't even in the camera friend. He is in the camera
friend. Yeah, you can see him. You can't tell that it's Aaron Yeager, but you can tell
by
somebody.
Just by himself. He finna
tell you.
Where is he normally at?
He failed, so he was just like over there out of the thing. But yeah, Austin put him back.
It's not a dude I want to
look exaggeration.
I'm gonna bring Bender from Futurama to put it next to him.
You got Bender?
Okay, where?
No, I can get him though.
You just got money like that.
Yeah.
Okay. Or is it gonna be a Funko Pop?
Nah.
As I say, we gotta
try to get something in similar size.
You know what's a big exaggeration that I would probably have? What? Is like talking to a girl. And then going back to my homie and just like
exaggerating what the experience was like or the conversations.
Or yeah, just like that. Like everything is truthful. I did talk to her. She did like me, but I probably made it seem like she was in love. And like
I probably have done that before.
Yeah. She asked me to come to the crib. I'm like, I got practice in the morning. You going to drive with a girl? Man, we drove around a city. Bit around a plex one time.
Yeah.
But that you said. The craziest thing about our high school is we went to middle school that was predominantly black. Mm. Then we went to a very diverse high school for what it was, but there was also a lot of white kids who went to different schools. So you know how I was getting finagled? When we went to high school, I would meet these people, gain friendships and whatever. They'd come back. They'd be like, man, you know, Janet? Yeah, man, hooked up with Janet.
Yeah, bro. No.
Hooked up, in my mind, was one thing.
Yeah.
It can mean 10 things.
Yes.
So for some people, that could have meant to just put the arm around her and watch the movie.
Mm-hmm.
A peck on the cheek. I had a dude tell me he hooked up with a girl, and then I was going into detail, and he told me he got a kiss on the cheek. But if I didn't go into detail, he's hooked up.
And this is just my personal thing. I think it's at least second base.
But what is that? That's my point. What is second base? Second base is so vague that a lot of people took that and just ran with it and made all of these different things. Mm-hmm. So I always finish. So, man, Derek come back, man. I just hooked up, blah, blah, blah. Be like, okay, look at me. That's my boy. That's my dog. Just to find out he gave her a hug and a kiss on the cheek.
Yeah. No, my thing was very close to that, but it was just the fact that we went from our like middle school to high school, and it was just like we were meeting all these new people, and then it was like you'll see this one dude, well, this random person, like dude named Devin or whatever, he'd be like, oh yeah, I know Jimmy from the other school, and it's like all the schools knew each other except from the people from our school.
What blew my mind is I went to somebody's house for a party.
Yeah.
Right hand to God. They lived across the street from Burr Ridge and didn't go to our school. I'm like, bro, how the hell you live right here? Literally walking distance. You have across the street from our school, our old middle school, is that park. Mm-hmm. To the left.
There's houses.
Yeah. They lived in that house on that same street, on that main street.
In our graduating class, I'm just talking about like, well, me and D Mills' class, they're probably, how many white people do you think there were? Probably like, because I could probably name or think about probably like 5 to 10 off the bat, but it was definitely not many at all.
We definitely were a predominantly black school.
It was,
we were.
I don't know if it still is because I haven't been there.
By far,
but it's just funny because it's like in the richest.
No, I'm saying when we went.
One of the richest towns in Illinois.
Yeah, literally.
Why is it funny?
Because they literally was like, we're not sending our kids to that school, that pocket school that has a little pocket of black kids. There's a lot of kids.
We're sending them to, what's the, OLP.
We're sending them to with KB.
Yeah.
With the good ones.
Yeah, that shit was weird. I was in a major minority.
You got the Bopper videos. Him and bro got the Bopper videos. Oh,
cut it the fuck out.
We live in the same neighborhood as Derrick Rose.
Yeah.
And they don't want to send their kid to that school.
I had went to our middle school in seventh grade. So when he got to high school, what I had started to realize was a lot of kids started off going to that middle school and then they transferred out because their parents saw how many black kids had went. So that was always.
And it's so great. It's actually a very good school.
Is it?
Yeah.
Our school was not a very good school. Hinsdale South was. The middle school was not a very good school.
I think it's still a pretty good school. There was a lot of people who went to that school and still became very successful.
Like, oh, well, I mean.
And like,
that's
like there's people like, that came out of there and became doctors and everything.
Are
like,
you going to put that on the middle school learning, though?
No, but I'm saying like it's still like a great transition from there to Hinsdale South.
I don't know if I can remember one thing I learned at Burr Ridge Middle School.
Yeah, we did. I'm not here to say it's the worst school in the world.
Right.
Yeah. But what I'm saying is we had shit going on in our school that I can understand. I'm not going to understand just moving your kid because every school is going to have different things. But we had people was wilding out, man. Yeah. That's all I'm going to say. People was wilding out. In my grade, we didn't get to go on a St. Louis trip. Wasn't it like a St. Louis trip or something?
Yep.
We couldn't go because they cut the phone cord in Miss Elder's class twice.
Oh, wow.
The phone cord, KB, because you didn't go to our school, was for her to call to the office when they was acting up. They had to install a phone. Then the kids say, oh, you're going to install a phone? Call them now.
But you know the funniest thing, though? You get sent to the quote-unquote big room. It's like Behavior Improvement Center, and you just go see Tyler Mom.
Tyler
worked there.
Shout out to Miss
Mom. The people that worked in the office was cool.
Super cool.
Yeah.
Super cool.
We didn't get to go because they said too many people were on free lunch, and like they felt like we couldn't afford it.
That's insane, bro.
They literally took away the football team.
Yeah. Then they brought it back.
Yeah. Took away the football team. Yeah, people, there was a lot of fights. There was, they cut the phone cord on Miss Elder. There was bus stuff. There was a lot of stuff going on. So it's like, but who's to say that that won't happen at other schools? Fights happen everywhere. But
yeah, kids, I feel like when you put a bunch of kids in a building, there's going to be fights, no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you're just that tight with your security to where there's never a fight in here. We got security everywhere. And even then, it's still going to happen.
We appreciate y'all watching.
KB like, I don't relate to that.
Or listen to this episode of Numbers on the Board. Be sure to go to notblive.com to get your tickets to our Las Vegas show. Tune in to our draft coverage on ESPN's YouTube channel, 8 o'clock Eastern time. We'll be there to see your favorite team mess up a draft pick again.
Peace. Who got them bopping videos?